Hello.
Today we are going to be showing you how to use the spreadsheet menu icon in the fx-9750GIII graphing calculator from Casio. We're going to use an example activity just to show you why you would be using a spreadsheet. And everything that I'm doing works on all Casio graphing calculators, but I'm using the fx-9750GIII, the newest in the graphing calculator line because of its really nice affordability and functionality. So here's an activity where you may be familiar with it. Students are given an option. They're doing a job and they're going to get paid for 30 days, and they can either get paid $1,000 a day or a penny on the first day, double that on the second day, double the next day. So each day it doubles from the day before, and they have to decide which payment plan do you think you should choose. Well, the question seems obvious at first. We'll obviously go with $1,000 a day, and the whole idea is, well, let's actually collect some data, let's do some comparison, let's look at some tables and some graphs and really make an informed decision. And they are going to see that a constant value versus an exponential value might have a different result. So we're using a spreadsheet because in a spreadsheet you have your tables and your columns, but you can use formulas, expressions, calculations to fill the tables in and do things very quickly instead of having to do it by hand using a calculator or those types of things. So we're going to arrow over here. So here I am in the menu. I'm going to arrow over to spreadsheet using my navigation button over here, or I could have just hit the number 4. I'm going to hit execute. That brings me to my spreadsheet. When you are in spreadsheet, you have to let the calculator know that you're starting a new spreadsheet. So you'll notice down here are my options, and I'm going to choose F1 for file and let it know that this is going to be a new one. And I'm just going to type in a word here, and I want to use alphabet. So alpha is red. You'll notice that the red numbers, the red icon or things above the numbers, the buttons are the letters. So I'm going to actually put my alpha lock on. So shift alpha, I have an alpha lock on now. And now let's just call this plans. So because basically we're comparing plans. So here's the P above the 4, the L is here, A, N, and then let's do an S because this is really planned. So once you finish typing whatever it is the title of your spreadsheet, hit execute, brings you to your spreadsheet. And now you'll see that your navigation button lets you move from cell to cell and row to row, those types of things. So I'm currently in column A, row 1, and I want my first row to be the descriptions of the numbers that are in those columns. So I'm going to use alphabet. So again, I want to hit alpha lock. And when you are entering in a spreadsheet, as if you were working with Excel as well, you would have to first let the calculator know that I am entering something that is text. So that's using this quotation here. So I'm going to hit that first. You'll see that that showed up here. And now I want my first column to be the days. So we're going to have 30 days, right? So there's D, A, Y. And once you finish, you hit execute. And so now that cell has text in it that represents what that column stands for. So let's do column B as our plan 1, so the $1,000 a day. So again, I'm going to hit alpha lock, and we're going to do the quotation first to let the calculator know that this is text, and then P. And then I actually want to turn off the lock, and I want P1, all right? And so now let's do column C as the other plan where we're doubling every day from the day before. So now I want alpha quotation to let it know it's text, alpha P, and this time it's gonna be plan 2. All right, so now let's go into our things, and here's where the spreadsheet's gonna come in handy. I know that my days are gonna go from 1 to 30 starting at this particular position right here. So I wanna enter 1 for the first day. So I'm gonna hit execute, but I don't wanna have to go all the way down. I could do 2, 3, all the way down to 30, but I wanna use the capability of a spreadsheet where I can actually fill in my rows if I know the process. So we're gonna go into edit. We're editing this session here. So I'm gonna hit edit by selecting F2, and I wanna be able to fill, and I don't see fill as an option here, so F6 always tells me there's more, and there's fill. So I'm gonna fill in, and it's saying, well, what is the formula you wanna fill in? So this brings us to where we're going to type in the formula. And you do, just like we had to do when we were doing text, we have to let the calculator know that we're entering a formula, something we want them to use repeatedly. And if, again, you're familiar with, say, Excel, you know you have to start a formula with the equal symbol. So we're going to enter our formula here by first doing this equal. So we, that, if you look, it's yellow over the decimal point here. And so we're going to do shift decimal first. That puts that equal sign in there. Now we enter our formula. So what is our formula? Well, we want for days, each day you're adding one. So we want the day we already have, which is A2. So we're going to enter A2. And we're going to add one to it. And that will give us the value for A3, which would be day two. So where do we want this formula to be used? So we're going to hit execute and set the formula. And now we're going to decide what's our range. Well, we want it to start on A3, right? Because A3 is going to take A2 from above, add one. That's the number for A3. And we want to go for 30 days. But remember, we started on A2. So we really need to go out to cell A31. So we're going to hit execute. And now we're going to hit F6 to execute and fill in our column. And you'll notice now, as we go down column one, it's going to go all the way to 31. All right. So let's think about the same thing here. So let's go over here to plan one. Plan one is 1,000 every day, right? So I know on day one, I'm going to have 1,000. And I'm going to hit execute. Well, I could type 1,000 30 times, but I don't want to do that. I want to use my formula again. So we're going to go to the fill option. This time the formula is different, however, because what am I doing? Every time I'm adding 1,000, I'm not doing a calculation. So I'm just going to enter the number 1,000. There is no actual formula, right? So hit execute. Well, where do I want to put that 1,000? Well, I want it to start on B3. But again, remember, we're going for 30 days. And we started one cell past one, so we want to go up to 31. Hit execute. So basically, this is saying enter 1,000 into all of these cells. And let's do it. So we're going to hit execute. So now you can see that 1,000 is in all of those cells. Now we come to plan two. And plan two, what's the start value? Well, you get a penny, so 0.01. Hit execute. The next day, it's going to double. And that would make it 0.02. Next day, that's going to double 0.04, right? And again, we don't want to have to do it. We want the spreadsheet capabilities to do that for us. So we're going to do another fill. This time we will use a formula. So remember, I want to let the calculator know this is a formula. I need to put that equal sign in first. So shift, period. And now what is my formula? Well, my, obviously the start value is C2. That's where I put that penny. What's happening to that C2? Well, it's doubling it. So that's multiplying by 2. So let's do C2 times 2. So we're going to double whatever that value is. And where do we want this formula to be applied? Well, we want it to be applied to C3, all the numbers below, whoops, and all the way up to 31 again. And so what it's going to do is it's going to always take the cell from above, multiply it by 2, and put it in the new cell. So that's the formula. So we're going to say, okay, that works. Let's execute. And so now you'll see there's my first day, 1 penny, 2 penny, double that, 4 pennies, double that, 8 pennies. And so students might now be going, you're still not making very much money. Well, like, this person's making $1,000 and you've made, you know, a couple bucks. But notice that as you go further down, the dollar value is increasing quite a bit. And now, on this day, we've made more, right? And then this day, we've made more. We've made a lot more. And as we keep going, we're making $10,000 and $20,000 because we're doubling very large amounts. And so maybe now they're seeing, wow, you're making a lot more. Like this, he made $1,000, but I made $167,000. Like insane amount of money right here. So this plan's looking really good, at least near the later days. And so now let's actually see what that looks like. So here's where we're going to go into how do you graph once you've got your values in your spreadsheets. So we're going to go into, we're going to hit exit here and get back to our options here. So I hit F6. Remember hitting this button here where you see the arrow means there's more. So here's my graph. So I'm going to hit graph. And I have to set up my graphs because I could have lots of different graphs. There's three different ones. So let's set up our graphs first. So graph one, we do want to see a scatter plot, and we do want it to be the days. So our graphs are going to be the days for the X, and the output's going to be the plans. So for our first graph, we do want the scatter plot, but our range here, we want to be just a little bit different here because we didn't start our numbers on A1, right? We started on A2. And we ended at A31, right? So that's our input X values. And we want the second column to be our numbers, but we started at B2, and again, we ended at B31. So once I've got that set up, and I think I'll keep the type there, okay? So we're gonna hit execute, that works. And so we've set up the first graph. So let's go up and now set up the second graph. So graph two, I also want to be a scatter plot. And again, I need to change my input. I still want it to be the days, but remember they started on the number value started on A2 and they ended on A31. And this time I want plan two. So plan two is in a completely different cell. So we want it to be cell C2, not 21, and we want to get rid of the B, and we want that to be cell, and I'm just using my alpha here, C31. And let's even change the type of mark so that they look different. So we use this for the first graph, so let's use an X, say, for the second, and hit execute. So we've set it up. Now let's make sure they're both turned on. So we've set them up first. Let's select which ones we want to be on. And number one tends to be on by default, but we also want to see number two, which was plan two. So let's just hit F1 here and turn it on. And now we've got both of them on. Let's hit F6 and draw them. And as you can see, visually, it looks like they're all very, very, well, it's really hard to see because remember the penny one is really low and this is 1,000. So the darker mark showing $1,000 every single day. So it's constantly 1,000. But as you can see, the penny one starts off, you can't even see it. And then all of a sudden it starts picking up, and then it's drastically different up here. Really different up here. And so students are starting to see, well, you know, you start out slow, but you really build fast. This is a different kind of rate. So did this one actually end up with more money? Because remember, this is what they're earning each day. So now maybe we want to add up the total. Maybe because you earned so many $1,000, you know, up to day, and we can now go back to our table. What day did the second plan go over 1,000? So up until day 18, you are earning more. You're earning $1,000 every day in the first plan. So you're earning more than you are in the second plan. But starting on day 18, the second plan starts earning a lot more. So is the total of each the same or different? So here's where you can now, again, using your cell capabilities, you could go down here and we're going to enter a formula just in this one cell. We don't need to fill everything, so we're gonna just use a formula. So remember, we're looking for the total and we need to do a formula. So we have to have that equals first to let the calculator know. So we're going to hit shift and then the period here, and that puts that equal sign there. Now we can enter our formula. Well, what is our formula? Our formula is we would like to do a sum of all the cells in a certain range. And so we're gonna hit cell here. So see, notice here's my choice, cell, and I want the sum of the cells. So notice it puts cell sum, and then now I'm gonna enter the range. So we know that we started and we're in column B, so we're gonna do alpha B, and we started at 2, and now I need to get that semicolon in. So if I hit exit, exit always brings you to the screen before. So when I hit exit, I'll see my semicolon. And now my last one was B31, so we're going to do alpha B and then enter 31, close my parentheses. And then when I hit execute, it's going to give me the sum for that. So in the plan one, $1,000 a day, I get $30,000, right? That's awesome. Well, let's see what this sum is here. And notice this looks like a decimal. This is really, if you look here in scientific notation. So that's 6 decimal places. This is a huge amount here. So let's do the same thing that we did before. Let's get the sum here. So we're going to do first enter the fact that it's an equation, so equals, and we want to do a cell calculation, so cell, and we want the sum, so F5, and this time it's C, so we want alpha C starting at 2, and let's hit exit to get that colon in there, so F3, and then we're going to C31, and close our parentheses and hit execute. And that is 7 decimal places, so that's a huge number compared to this. So starting with a penny, doubling over 30 days, you're going to make millions of dollars. So this would be the better plan. So students are seeing multiple ways to do this. This is exponential. And now if you look at the activity, they have to come with a way to create an equation so that they see the difference. So this is a really nice activity that explores a lot of different things, lots of representations. So that's how you use the spreadsheet, entering formulas in single cells or filling, making graphs from your spreadsheet. So have fun exploring that.